graduate school Seung-Hyun Lee from Gyeongsang University. I will be presenting on a study summer performance evaluation of treated carbon nanotube buckypapers for use as a summer interface material. As the contents, introduction, experimental details, resulting discussion, and conclusion. First is an introduction. Cool TIM thermal interface materials are used to aid thermal conduction between mechanically mated surfaces such as a heat sink. When two materials come into contact, the heat conduction decreases due to the air gap formed on the surface. As shown in the figure 1, by using a material with good thermal conductivity, the resistance generated by air gap is reduced. We selected vertical carbon nanotube as a thermal interface material. Vertical CNT has many properties, and among them, we have focused on the reason that appear on the screen. Vertical carbon nanotube has excellent thermal properties and is a good component for thermal transport. They conduct heat by the vibration of the covalent bonds and carbon atoms. The stiffness of carbon bonds transmits vibration to the entire nanotube and show excellent thermal conductivity. These properties are decreasing thermal resistance formed by air gap. And we added cellulose nanocrystal to CNT-based buckypaper. Cellulose nanocrystal has strong strength. It can improve durability and reinforce heat conduction, and good compatibility with other materials. Next is experimental details. These are samples that have been tested. A total of 5 buckypaper samples were made. The first sample is untreated CNT. Second, oxidized CNT using sulfuric acid, nitric acid, and hydrochloric acid. Third, in the second oxidized CNT, added 2 CNC 0.06%. Fourth, on the oxidized CNT added to CNC 0.08%. Lastly, on the oxidized CNT added to CNC 0.18%. This slide buckypaper manufacturing process. First, dispersion vertical CNT. To disperse each sample, the strion process was applied for 1 hour. Followed by ultrasonication for 2 hours. Second, filtration. Distilled water is filtered through the dispersed nanofluid using a vacuum filter, leaving only the vertical CNT particles. Lastly, the filtered vertical CNT is dried for 1 day and separated from the membrane filter. Then, the buckypaper was completed. The ASTM D5470 equation was used to calculate the thermal resistance value. D5470 is a test method that uses the thermal equilibrium method to determine the thermal conductivity of the material by using the law that the amount of heat flowing through the sample is the same before and after. As shown in the figure 5, we drill 6 holes in 2 copper blocks, including the surface of the copper block, insert the thermal couple, and see the temperature change. This equation keeps heat on the top and cold on the bottom. When the temperature of the copper block reaches a steady state, we use the temperature to find the thermal resistance value. Figure 6 is experimental setup. A copper block was wrapped with an insulator for an experiment, and on the right, each buckypaper sample was put between the cup of blood. In all experiments, a weight of about 2 kg was applied. Next slide is result and discussion. It is a graph of sample when the steady state is reached. Figure 7 is show temperature graph of respective channels. CNT buckypaper untreated showed a thermal resistance value of 1.526. Next, the thermal resistance value of the oxidized CNT was 1.340. From here, a graph is shown for concentration of CNC added to CNT. The resistance value of buckypaper with 0.06 weight percent of CNC added is 1.217. The resistance value of buckypaper with 0.08 weight percent of CNC added is 1.196. Lastly, the thermal resistance value of the buckypaper manufactured by adding 0.1 weight percent CNC was 2.508. These values are shown in the table on the next slide. Looking at the table, it can be seen that a thermal resistance value of oxidized CNT is lower than that of raw CNT, and the thermal resistance value is lowered by adding a certain amount of CNC to it. When 0.1 weight percent of CNC was added, the durability of the buckypaper was good, but the resistance value was not good. When comparing the 5 samples, it was found that the thermal resistance value was the lowest when the amounts of CNT and CNC were the same. Thermal conductivity may vary slightly depending on the thickness of the sample. Last of all, the conclusion. In this study, a thermal conductivity measuring device was manufactured to test the thermal conductivity of various treated multi-wires carbon nanotube-based buckypaper. The calculation of the thermal resistance value is ASTM D5470 has been conducted. The result of the calculation showed that the thermal resistance value is lower due to the removal of impurities during the oxidation treated of CNT. Besides, where the same amount of CNC was added as CNT, it was confirmed that the resistance value decreased. In conclusion, we show that CNT-based buckypaper has low thermal resistance value, is eco-friendly, and easy to install compared to conventional heat dissipating materials, and can be an alternative materials as thermal interface material. This concludes the research presentation. If you have any questions, please send them to my email. Thank you for your listening.